The plight of domestic workers in Arabia. While serving as the Director of Public Affairs and Communication in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Kenya, I encountered many cases of abuse of Kenyans working in Arabia. My simple advice is this: never take up domestic work in Arab countries. Do not, however much money they offer you. Let me explain. Although there is a key financial incentive to migrate, many women also do so because they are seeking adventure, independence, training, and upward social mobility. Unfortunately, most of them realize too late that they made the wrong choices. Women often incur substantial debts and pay recruitment agencies exorbitant fees to finance their migration. Relying on employment agencies and brokers, migrant domestic workers enter contractual bondage with employers whom they have never met before, leaving themselves vulnerable to abuse and exploitation. The employers, who are nothing but slaveholders, often use contracts as a means to legitimate and disguise the practice of slavery. You must therefore know that by accepting a job as a domestic worker in Arab countries, you have sold yourself into slavery. In order to migrate to work in Saudi Arabia or United Arab Emirates, she must first secure a visa through a method of sponsorship known as kafala, which legally binds the worker to her employer. Although both the sponsor and worker are capable of breaking the contract, this ostensible equality is merely a ruse, because if the worker breaks her contract, she must pay the cost of a return ticket. She may also be fined or forced to pay debts to the recruiting agency. Through this system of sponsorship, the fate of the migrant worker is entirely dependent upon the goodwill of an employer who, at any time, can threaten her deportation if unsatisfied. Once in their host countries, these migrants are immediately required to surrender their passports to the employers. Thus, even before the worker steps foot in her host country, the systems of exploitation are already in place. Due to the individualized working environment of household labor, female domestic servants are the group most vulnerable to exploitation in Saudi Arabia and United Arab Emirates. Domestic workers are often denied freedom of movement and are either locked inside or forbidden to leave the home without permission. Violence against maids includes physical attacks ranging from rape to slapping. Other forms of violence include overwork, including forcibly working in more than one household, and the refusal of days off, non-payment of wages, or a reduced salary. Maids also often experience poor living conditions, such as lack of food and privacy. Physical violence is usually perpetrated by the female employer or madam of the household. Most workers have reported suffering from more than one type of violence during the course of their employment, and many are so traumatized by the experience that it even negatively affects their ability to reintegrate into society upon returning home. I have met many women who will never be themselves after that experience in Arab countries. For foreign domestic workers, there are a few options available to deal with abuse. If escapee maids file police complaints against their sponsors, they are often arrested for running away or accused of lying. Due to the seemingly voluntary nature of migrant labor, It is an unfortunate reality that many of these women effectively enslave themselves abroad in hopes of improving their economic situation at home. This is not to suggest that migrants are to blame for their plight once the choice has been made and the contract signed. All future choices are restricted or non-existent. Most of these domestic servants are unaware of what they are getting into, expecting to be paid the equivalent of $800 per month, and instead finding their pay to be $100 a month, if anything at all. This deception, combined with the contract system, limits the mobility of the migrant domestic worker and leaves her at the mercy of employers who may also beat or sexually assault her. My advice is, do not take up domestic work in Arab countries. Before you take the decision, listen to our video from a survivor entitled My Life as a Slave Maid in Arabia. On that note, we come to the end of this video. Do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel.